President, please be seated.
The chamber now is back in session. And the floor is given to Judge Fens to issue the rulings on the request by the co-prosecutors. You may now proceed, Judge Fens.
Thank you. The chamber needs into evidence the one map identified by the prosecutor. Which is the Cambodian road network map without any annotations. As to the other maps, the chamber permits the use of those annotated maps during the expertise or during the time the expert is heard. The way we understand it, these are basically visualization tools are here to show the representativeness of samples taken in various studies. This is something, the accuracy of that is easily to be checked by chambers and parties. And this is an expert, so there is no danger that she will be unduly influenced. If she's shown this map and she says, no, it's not true, she can tell us immediately.
So, as to further requests to admit them into evidence, the chamber is waiting for requests should they come. La chambre attend ces autres requêtes si ces requêtes sont présentées.
President, thank you, Judge Fens.
President, je vous remercie, Madame la Juge.
In questioning the expert,
pour l'interrogatoire de l'expert.
In accordance with Rule 91 bis of the internal rule of the ECC, the floor is first given to the co-prosecutors before other parties. The combined time for the co-prosecutors and lead co-lawyers for civil parties is three sessions. You may now proceed. Song Chawan, thank you. Mr. President, thank you. Good morning, Your Honours, everyone in and around the courtroom, and good morning, the expert. My name is Song Chawan. I am the Deputy National Co-Prosecutor, and I have some questions to discuss with you, Ms. Expert. Earlier, the chamber asked you about your academics background.
La chambre vous a posé un certain nombre de questions au sujet de votre parcours universitaire.
Before I put some question to you, I would like to inform you that I will first ask you about the marriage before the Khmer Rouge time, because I want the chambers to understand the differences between the marriage just in the before the Khmer Rouge and those after the Khmer Rouge.
Distingue les mariages avant les Khmer Rouge des mariages pendant les Khmer Rouge.
I would like to ask you, the expert, to describe about the marriages before the Pol Pot's time or Khmer Rouge time. Before Pol Pot came to power, were there traditions and customs applied in relation to marriage before that period? Did the parents of both sides attend the marriage at the time?
Les parents des deux côtés étaient-ils présents au mariage?
Thank you very much. To answer to your question about the traditional marriage before the Khmer Rouge time, I don't have any accounts from the French colonial time or the Japanese occupation time, so perhaps what I can explain is only from 1950s or 1960s after the Sihanouk regime, which I would call tradition, and immediately before the Khmer Rouge. The traditional marriages in Cambodian society was arranged by the parents and agreed upon by the parents. In regard to the women's decision-making power, there was almost zero. So a daughter was given the instruction or order to marry with somebody by her parents. And mostly the daughters were expecting their parents to make a decision for her. On the other hand, the boys had more freedom, and boys could initiate their own marriages by proposing to his parents or guardians or relatives, who could approach to the parents of a girl that he wants to marry. At any case, mostly the weddings were arranged by the parents and decided by the parents. So even though a boy wanted to marry with a girl that he loves, if parents disapproved, it could have been extremely difficult for him to proceed to seek for the approval from the marriage. Once the agreement was done among both parties, meaning the parents of the groom and parents of the bride, then if the family follows a very traditional way, they would have an engagement ceremony. But immediately before the war, after especially the coup, this ceremony was not done because of the very difficult situation and the bombing. But anyway, the process after the approval of the both parents would be to set the date for the wedding ceremony. And the traditional, the fortune teller might be called to decide on the date, or the parents may decide. And then the date is set, and it's a huge, traditionally it's a huge ceremony, normally done for 3 days, including many ceremonies, with a lot of Buddhist monks participating in the ceremonies, and a lot of people in the villages were invited to participate. So it's not a personal matter, it's a family matter between the two parties, two families, and also it's a communal matter that the people in the village were invited to authorize such a marriage. They unfortunately, immediately before the Khmer Rouge, because the war was becoming very tough, a lot of marriages were very simplified, and many people could marry only within 1 day, and no lightning and no big sounds. But it's only for like 3-4 years, immediately before the Khmer Rouge. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Question, merci.
To clarify the issue, I would like you to make a further clarification about the traditional marriage before the Khmer Rouge.
Toujours au sujet des mariages traditionnels marriages involved avant les Khmer
Rouge. By parents, and did parents decide on marriages, or were decisions involved from the authorities in the local areas as well?
La décision, ou est-ce que les autorités locales participaient thank aussi you very à much. Cette décision?
The to be réponse. Accurate,
merci. Pour être précis,
mostly for the parents of the bride, they decide the marriage. And for the groom side, the parents of the groom might decide or they may approve the proposal from the groom. And how it was authorized was that it could have been registered in the local authorities, but mostly that local authorities, such as village chief, was invited to join the wedding ceremony. And this is a process to authorize the marriage.
Était invité au mariage, ce qui constituait en soi une procédure d'autorisation.
Question.
Question.
Were the chiefs of commune and villages attending as witnesses, or did they attend to formalize the marriage?
Ou étaient-ils là pour valider ou formaliser, officialiser le mariage?
Excuse me, I do not have answer to this question.
Réponse. Pardonnez-moi, je n'ai pas la réponse à cette question.
Question. Another question is about the customs to select the partners before the Khmer Rouge time. You have briefly explained that, but I want to you to expand further. Concerning the selection of partners, did the older people consult with one another before allowing the would-be husband and wife to consider and discuss as well? What was the process of selection? Could you expand on the matter? And who was involved in the selection process and also decision-making process?
Excuse me, so this is question about the marriage before the Khmer Rouge, is it correct?
Vous me posez la question sur le mariage
let me continue.
Avant les Khmer Rouge, c'est
the,
ça? Alors,
your question is about the selections of the partners in the marriage. Who is involved in selecting the partner to
a groom
and the bride, right?
Pour choisir les futurs
the,
époux.
Let me rephrase. For the single girls
Alors,
who are not yet married, their parents decide.
C'était les parents.
But many of the girls lost their parents or parents before the war, according to my study. In that case, her sisters, her brothers, her relatives, whoever take care
Donc,
of this girl, made a decision, and the girl did not have any decision-making power to say yes or no. It was decided upon her. For the groom, a boy, single boy, who has not yet married,
he
could propose to his parents or relatives, whoever who has the authority, to arrange his marriages. So it could be from the boy to the elders. And then it is now the elders' hand to approve or to allow and then to decide and to start negotiation with the parents of the groom, to the bride, sorry. So decision-making power lies on basically on the parents. And the selection in that matter also, the parents selected who is a nice match for their daughters or for their son.
Ou le meilleur parti pour leur fils.
Before the Khmer Rouge time, why did
Question.
Parents involve in the decision to marry their children?
Pourquoi les parents intervenaient-ils dans la décision
Thank
de mariage
much.
Avant la période de
traditionally in Cambodian
réponse,
culture
merci.
As in many other
de façon
cultures
dans la culture cambodgienne
children
dans
were not
cultures,
understood as a person who has the full rights parents were understood as
les parents,
not properties but belongings to the parents
les filles étaient
so
considérées
parents
comme appartenant, pardon,
thought
bien,
they have to make a decision
parents,
for everything about their children including from the education to the marriage which is
enfants,
the most important issues for many Cambodians so that's why parents had to engage in the decision making
voilà
of the decision for the marriage of the children
dans la prise de décision
it's not only for the marriage
enfants.
Children's life were decided by the parents
c'était toute la vie des enfants qui étaient décidée par leurs parents parce que les parents étaient les enfants étaient considérés comme appartenant à leurs parents
question could men or women refuse the marriage proposed by the senior people
question et lorsqu'une proposition était faite par un aîné les jeunes gens pouvaient-ils refuser
As far as I understand from my research,
d'après ce que
almost
les recherches
all females
montré,
before the Khmer Rouge time, they expected
Rouge,
and hoped their mothers, fathers to make a decision for them. So there was no option to say no because they are waiting
donc,
for their spouse to be decided by the parents.
Elles attendaient tout simplement qu'un époux soit choisi pour elles,
and
par
for
leurs parents.
The boy,
garçons,
I would say technically he could say no, but I don't have any accounts that the boys refused to say no to the decision by the parents.
Ou aurait rejeté la décision prise par ses parents.
Question: could you bring up examples
question.
In relation to
pouvez-vous nous
the
donner
reasons
des exemples?
That men or women refuse to get married? So what were the circumstances make a man or woman refuse to get married?
Des exemples ou quelles étaient les causes qui faisaient qu'un homme ou une femme refusait de se marier?
The one woman that I met in my study, she refused to marry before the Khmer Rouge, but consequently she was forced to marry in the Khmer Rouge, which was very unfortunate. She could refuse to marry before the Khmer Rouge because she wanted to be a medical doctor and she was studying in the medical school. And her parents decided on her marriage and brought a very nice man to marry with her.
Et lui avait présenté
and she
un
said
bon
no.
Mais elle a refusé.
She could escape
elle
because her younger sister
à se soustraire
was
à ce
forced
mariage
to marry with that man.
C'est sa sœur cadette
that's
qui
one example
a été forcée
I can recall.
D'épouser cet homme. Voilà un exemple dont je me souviens.
Question. Were men or women punished for refusing to marry before the Khmer Rouge time?
Question. Et avant la période
you
de Khmer Rouge,
brought
the
one example about the woman who refused to get married. So were men or women punished for refusing to marry?
It's an interesting question. I don't know, I've never thought about it, but I don't
voilà une question très intéressante. Je n'ai jamais réfléchi, mais je ne me souviens pas.
A boy or a girl was sanctioned or punished for not agreeing to the marriage
ou une fille aurait été sanctionnée parce qu'elle n'aurait pas consenti au mariage.
Non.
Décidé par les parents, non.
Question. In relation to the traditional marriage before the Khmer Rouge.
Question. En ce qui concerne
and,
le mariage traditionnel avant
the marriages
des Khmer Rouge.
Were in, were known to the couples. I would like to refer you to the October 2014 study of
mariage.
The language stressor Kim and Tang entitled quote unquote like ghost changes body. A study on the impact
like
of forced marriage,
body,
marriages under the Khmer Rouge regime,
forcés, des
TBO.
De forcés. C'est une étude document du TBO qui a été fait, qui date de 2014, et c'est le document
E3/96/14 at Eon in
614,
in
Khmer, le RN en Khmer 0, est 0
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3.
4, 3.
There is no French translation.
Il n'y a pas de traduction en français.
The author quotes from Irihara.
L'auteur cite
the anthropologist.
Un anthropologue.
President, you may now proceed. Counsel for
vous
Mr.
Avez
Kusumpong.
La parole à la défense de Kusumpong.
My apologies for interrupting, Mr. President.
We did not get the English ERN.
I know that there's no French ERN, but could you please repeat the English ERN?
President, please repeat the ERN.
Pouvez-vous répéter l'ERN en anglais?
Co-procureur, thank you.
Co-procureur.
The document is E3/96/14/01/03/70/40, that is English ERN, and I seek permission from the President to display the document on the screen so that the experts can follow. In the study by the linguist,
dans cette étude qui a été réalisée par
the book studies about the forced marriage in the Khmer Rouge time,
and he
referred to the work of Hebi Hara,
cette personne se the sur les detailed study d'une autre of personne.
Anthropology
on villagers during the Khmer Rouge time. Des villageois sous les Khmer Rouges.
And the description is about the days of marriage,
and
the description is about the Swai village.
Ici, la situation dans le village de Swai.
And he describes about the customs and tradition of marriage
l'étude
from 1959 through 1960. Hibara describes about a traditional marriage, and I would like to quote.
Décrit le mariage traditionnel, et je cite,
according to an ideal custom, a young man makes his own choice as to whom to marry,
and once having decided, asks
his parents to begin negotiations with the girl's family. When the
latter
receives a marriage proposal, the young woman herself is consulted and again, according to tradition, is free to accept or reject the offer. Further, in this study by the linguist and others, the same document
and
Khmer is two pages below.
Deux pages plus loin en Khmer.
After reviewing the available research on traditional Cambodian marriages on the issue of the consent between men and women to the marriage, concluded the following.
Sur le mariage cambodgien traditionnel,
quote,
et la question du consentement entre hommes et
femmes, in summary, traditional weddings,
je cite,
before the Khmer Rouge time, were largely
avant l'époque des Khmer Rouges,
arranged.
Étaient en grande partie arrangés. Les mariages arrangés.
And it's very important for the family and also for the ancestor.
Et
the
c'était très important pour
marriages,
la famille et pour les ancêtres.
They were largely arranged and most often with the consent of the intended.
Arrangés, la plupart du temps avec
and
le consentement
really concerned
des personnes
according to available research.
Et rarement forcé
based on the
à se
research which I have just read to you,
bien, à partir de ces éléments de recherche que je viens de vous lire,
do these opinions accord with your findings, namely that in the traditional Cambodian marriage, regardless of arrangement made by parents, that men participate in women? So do all the opinions accord with your findings?
Les hommes et les femmes avaient véritablement un choix dans le mariage traditionnel cambodgien.
Thank you very much. Yes, I think it's largely the same.
Oui, je crois que dans une grande mesure, nos opinions concordent.
But from my studies, even though the single girls were consulted by her parents about her marriage, they blindly agreed to the marriage. So I don't think so. It was a genuine consent that she really wanted to marry with that man from her own choice.
Je ne pense pas que c'était là son propre choix.
In order to clarify this point,
question, pour préciser ce point,
the woman who has married was she consulted and received this information from the man that she is supposed to get married before she made her decision whether to marry him or to refuse the proposal?
La décision soit de l'épouser, soit de rejeter la proposition?
It depends on the parents.
Réponse, tout dépend des parents.
As to how much information they give to their daughters.
Et de la quantité d'informations qu'ils donnaient à leurs filles.
The many women that I interviewed, the wedding day was the first time that they met with their husband.
C'est le jour du mariage qu'elles ont rencontré pour la première fois leur mari. Elles savaient très peu sur leur mari avant le mariage.
They don't regard the women. They don't regard as unfortunate marriage, but they were happy to accept and follow the decision by their parents.
Elles ne se considéraient pas malheureuses par rapport à ces mariages et étaient plutôt fières de suivre la décision prise par les parents.
Regarding the decision to get married,
question, en ce qui concerne family choice, la décision de mariage, était-ce
was it done through le choix de la famille participation of the authorities?
Ou la décision était-elle prise avec la participation des autorités?
If I understand the question correctly,
réponse, si je comprends bien votre question,
it is 100% family matter.
C'est une question familiale à 100%. Les autorités sont informées après que tout a été décidé au sein de la famille.
Thank you. Just briefly describe
l'accusation,
about
je vous remercie. Vous venez de décrire brièvement le mariage traditionnel.
It details the participation of a certain people.
Qui nécessitait la participation de certaines personnes.
And I'd like to ask you about the timing of the wedding itself. When there was a proposal from a man to the to a woman's side,
timing du
what was the gap between the actual proposal and the wedding day itself?
Et si oui, quel délai séparait la proposition du mariage par exemple, l'homme faisait la proposition de mariage aux parents de la future mariée. Combien de temps s'écoulait-il avant que le mariage ne soit célébré, avant que l'approbation ne soit donnée et le mariage célébré?
How much time was required
from the very
first initiation of the marriage until the marriage ceremonies? But I don't recall any marriages that were arranged in a short manner, meaning it may take months, it may take a half year,
except
some marriages in 1973 or 1974,
when parents of
the daughters were very worried about the security situation of the daughters, I have some accounts that they were rushed into the marriage.
J'ai entendu des récits selon
they were not ready to marry, but parents
le mariage a été précipité.
The marriage for their daughters,
la fille n'était pas prête à se marier, mais
so,
les parents voulaient accélérer la procédure de mariage à cause des bombardements intensifs. Pour les parents, c'était extrêmement important
besides
que leurs filles bénéficient d'une protection
and
immédiate.
It's not nationwide, it's only some areas. Besides this,
outre cette période temporelle, cela ne s'étend pas sur toute la nation. Je dirais que le processus de mariage, depuis
l'initiation du mariage
à la négociation avec les familles, je dirais que cela prend des mois.
In the cases that the engagement took place before the marriage,
question, dans le cas où il y
what was
des
the waiting period between the engagement and the marriage? Can you give an estimate period, for example, the shortest and the longest?
Pouvez-vous nous donner une estimation, une fourchette? entre la période de temps la plus courte et la plus longue. Réponse. Je suis désolée, je n'ai pas de réponse à cette question.
Thank you. And based on your study and research,
d'après vos études et vos recherches,
during the Khmer Rouge regime, what were the main factors that led the men and the women and the parents on both sides to consider the marriage and whether the marriage should be held according to the tradition?
Le mariage. Et ces mariages se déroulaient-ils selon la tradition? Réponse. Sous la Khmer Rouge, le mariage était complètement différent des mariages traditionnels.
What are the main factors?
Question.
That the Cambodian people prior to the Khmer Rouge regime, believes that traditional marriage was important to them.
Avant le régime des Khmer Rouge, les Cambodgiens estimaient que le mariage était important pour eux. Quels étaient les principaux facteurs
traditional marriage
qui présidaient à ce fait?
Should include the participation of the
le mariage traditionnel
and family
inclut la participation des parents et des membres de
weddings.
La famille qui viennent fêter le mariage.
This was missing in the Khmer Rouge time.
C'est ce facteur qui était manquant pendant le régime des Khmer Rouge.
And about the men and the women who had to marry one another. Was there any process of thinking about their social status? For example, the poor could marry the wealthy family.
Relatif au statut social, lorsqu'un homme et une femme voulaient se marier, est-ce que les pauvres pouvaient épouser
with the one with lower education?
Les personnes instruites
pouvaient
épouser
for those marriages that took place prior to the Khmer Rouge regime.
Instruites. Je vais parler du processus de mariage. Sous le régime des Khmer Rouge.
It was the marriages before
réponse,
the Khmer Rouge was very much family issues.
Le mariage
so
avant le Khmer Rouge était plus une question de famille.
In the marriage
les deux familles étaient impliquées
should
dans le mariage
agree upon the marriage.
Et donner leur approbation
so from
au
this
mariage.
View, it would be very difficult
de ce point
to
de
match
vue,
a girl
il était très difficile
from completely different from social background
d'apparier une
to marry to a man who is living in another world.
Différent.
So mostly, for example, the farmers were married among the farmers, merchants were married among the merchants, educated.
Se marier
at that time,
entre
living
eux,
only
les commerçants
in the cities,
entre eux, les personnes
they
instruites
were marrying,
qui vivaient
married among
généralement
the educated.
Dans la ville,
so for example,
étaient
educated daughters at that time was very rare because girls could not
les
go to school.
Les filles éduquées à l'époque étaient très
so
rares.
Girls who had education
car les filles n'allaient pas à l'école.
That her parents would arrange
ainsi, une fille éduquée s'attendait à ce que
marriages of her to a man who has high education.
Arrange son mariage avec un homme qui a un niveau d'instruction élevé.
Thank you. Regarding
l'accusation, merci.
Day of the marriage itself under
en
the Khmer Rouge regime.
Le jour du mariage lui-même, proprement dit,
how
sous
was
le régime
the
des Khmer Rouge?
Day start and who
comment commençait
participated
cette journée?
In the wedding?
Qui participait
were there
au mariage?
Who were the elders or the family relatives
y avait-il des
aînés? Of both sides? And was it of important nature that they had to attend such a wedding ceremony?
Et était-il important pour ces personnes d'assister
excuse me,
à
so
cette
it's in
à
the
cérémonie
time.
De mariage?
Before.
Réponse. Excusez-moi, c'est bien sous les Khmer Rouge
before the Khmer
ou avant?
Rouge time, at the wedding,
réponse. Avant les Khmer Rouge.
It was a time when the community itself
de mariage
welcomed and authorized pour la communauté de se réunir
et autoriser le mariage. The people marrying, but also the siblings,
ce n'était pas
parents,
non seulement les personnes qui se mariaient, mais également from far les proches, away, les membres de la famille, les frères et sœurs,
people in the villages,
les parents éloignés,
include the neighbors,
même
maybe
les
sellers,
membres de la communauté, the local les habitants authorities, du village,
such as chief,
les voisins,
et cetera,
les autorités locales, les chefs de village, etc. Toutes ces personnes étaient censées participer.
Thank you.
L'accusation, merci.
Also touching upon the same topic,
toujours
and in relation
sur le même
to
sujet.
The period before the Khmer Rouge regime, after
the
couples were just wed, did they have to live together?
Après le mariage.
And if they were to disagree with one another, did they have the right to proceed with the divorce?
Pouvait-il divorcer? Avait-il le droit de le faire?
Technically, it was possible.
Réponse: techniquement, c'était possible.
The married couple seek for divorce.
Le couple
but it was very, very rare.
Marié pouvait demander le divorce.
Because
mais
at that time,
très
Cambodia was still following the polygamy system.
Le Cambodge
so men could keep several wives.
Polygame,
there is no reason that he may divorce a wife.
Femmes.
He could just keep several multiple wives.
De divorcer.
And for women's side,
de
it's a
épouses.
Very shameful conduct if
femme,
she is divorced
le divorce
at any cost. So it was extremely rare
honte.
From both male side and female side reasons that they had a divorce.
Que,
les but there was a divorce, and people, I have an account that woman divorced. And I could
et
imagine that it was
an
extremely tough
divorcé.
Decision for a woman
je me souviens que
to
c'est une décision
decide on the decision from her side.
Pour une femme de prendre la décision
but it was possible
de divorcer.
To divorce somebody.
Mais c'était possible de divorcer d'une personne.
Thank you. And after the
l'accusation, merci.
Were couples
après le mariage,
expressly ordered or told that they should consummate the marriage?
Les couples recevaient-ils explicitement
or did they
l'ordre
have the right to
de
make their own
le mariage?
Decision?
Leur demandait-on de le faire? Ou avaient-ils le droit de
to my
understanding,
it's a taboo to talk about it.
Réponse à ma compréhension, c'est un tabou
so
d'en parler.
So parents would not tell the daughters or sons
les parents
how they should behave
ne disaient pas à leur fille ou leur
in
fils
the night of the weddings, et cetera.
Comment ils devaient se comporter la nuit de noces,
the,
etc.
I remember some women were told to
je
be
me rappelle
obedient to the husband in the night of the wedding,
une femme d'être obéissante
but
envers
it's
son mari.
Against
pendant
Cambodian
la nuit de
noces. Tradition to talk about sexuality among the women, even between the mother and the daughters.
Parmi les femmes, y compris
I met a lot of women who
entre mère
were
et
not
fille.
Educated
j'ai rencontré
about
de nombreuses femmes,
their reproductive health, such as menstruation.
Sur leur santé
so
reproductive,
in the society where even the mother or sisters could not teach about even the menstruation issue,
ne pouvait pas
I
être
don't think
enseigné
so that the parents educated anything about sexuality after the marriage.
Je ne pense pas que
and for men's side,
qu'elle recevait une quelconque
I don't
éducation
think
sexuelle
so that parents,
après le mariage ou dans le mariage.
I didn't hear any stories that men were educated in that
je
way.
N'ai jamais entendu dire que des hommes avaient reçu une instruction dans ce sens.
Common or casual conversations that people before the Khmer Rouge, or even now, have in Cambodian society, is people tend to ask about a child. Do you have a child?
Avant et même
how many children do they have? It's a very common conversation. So it could be assumed that after the marriage, parents were inquiring about their daughters or sons, are you expecting a child, do you have a child, etc. But I think that's the maximum of their inquiry level in regard to the reproductive health issues.
Ils attendaient un enfant, et c'est jusque-là qu'ils pouvaient aller. Lorsqu'il s'agissait des débats sur la santé reproductive,
des enfants.
And based again on your research, were there cases where the elders or the parents of the bride or the groom
ou les parents
ever instructed them
du futur marié ou de la future mariée
that they had to produce children in order to carry on their
family tradition des enfants pour perpétrer la lignée familiale.
And if there were such cases, did you know whether any of the men or women have the right to refuse to such instructions?
Les hommes et les femmes concernés pouvaient refuser d'obéir à de telles instructions.
I do not recall any accounts that
je ne me souviens d'aucun témoignage en ce sens où les parents
to their children before the Khmer Rouge that they should have a child in order to keep the family line. But I may be wrong, because even nowadays in Cambodia, parents are asking this.
And
I don't know if it's called instructions.
Les parents demandent de telles informations à leurs enfants. Je ne sais pas si on peut appeler cela des instructions.
Whether there were instructions or advice.
Question. Que ce soit des instructions ou des conseils.
That they should produce children.
On leur.
Did the couple have the right to refuse to such advice or instructions? Or did they have to follow it?
I'm sorry, I forgot to answer the second question.
The
réponse, je m'excuse, j'ai oublié de répondre
English,
à la deuxième question. En anglais, j'ai entendu
instructed that they should have a child,
que les parents leur donnaient pour instruction d'avoir
if I understand
un enfant.
It correctly,
et si
I
je
don't
comprends
think
bien,
so that parents said
je ne
they
pense
should
pas
have a child.
Que les parents disaient qu'ils devaient
But
avoir
they
un enfant.
Would suggest
les parents
that they
se contentaient de suggérer qu'ils voulaient un petit-fils, qu'ils
so
voulaient avoir un petit-fils.
Directing the same thing
ou une petite fille.
That the married couple should have a child, but I don't think so parents would
sens,
instruct
hein,
their daughters or sons that
marié,
you should have a child.
Devaient avoir les enfants, mais je ne pense pas que les parents
but
leur donnaient une instruction
hand,
spécifique
said,
there is ou un
a social
ordre dans ce sens.
Not only from
comme
the parents
je l'ai dit, il y a une
pression
sociale
from the community,
provenant non seulement des parents ou des frères et sœurs, mais également de la communauté.
Societies, you should have a child.
Une fois qu'on
this
est marié dans la société cambodgienne,
we still have
il
now.
Faut avoir un enfant. C'est la pression
and
sociale que nous subissons
women
actuellement.
Or men had the right
est-ce que
to say
les
no
femmes ou les hommes avaient le droit de dire non
before the Khmer Rouge time?
Avant le régime des Khmer Rouges?
Technically, it was possible because there was an abortion possible for women.
Car il était possible pour les femmes de pratiquer
l'avortement. But if I
imagine
whether women or men said
mais
no to their parents that they choose not to have a child, it's revolutionary and it's
je crois que si les hommes et les femmes disaient non à leurs parents, ce serait
I cannot imagine
une mesure révolutionnaire
that
et ce serait inimaginable.
Had
je
n'en,
je n'imagine même pas que les familles avant les Khmer Rouges tenaient de telles conversations.
So, to rephrase it, I don't
pour
think so from my research,
je ne pense pas
instructed
que d'après mes recherches,
a child,
les parents
that they
donnaient
should have a child.
Instructions
there
à leurs
was
enfants
not such an instruction by the parents,
des enfants,
but they would
les parents ne donnaient pas de telles instructions, mais ils leur demandaient,
so
ils leur disaient qu'ils aimeraient avoir un petit-fils ou une petite-fille. Ce n'était donc pas des instructions
daughter,
en tant que telles.
If you are married,
si
as you are
un parent
now,
dit
are you
à sa fille,
a baby,
maintenant que tu es mariée, est-ce
I
que tu attends un enfant? Je n'imagine pas
I
une situation selon laquelle la fille répondrait à son père ou à, son mère, à sa mère,
so
j'ai décidé de ne pas avoir un enfant,
and
je ne pense pas qu'il soit possible à une femme
man,
de le dire.
They would not say that.
Il en va de même pour l'homme.
Mm. This may be my last question to conclude the area that I cover.
Ce sera ma dernière question sur le thème que j'ai abordé.
Meru's regime. After the couples got wed.
Après le mariage.
Did the couple have the right to consummate the marriage by themselves?
Le couple avait-il le droit de choisir de consommer le mariage
by the local authority, for example, from the village, commune, or district authority locales, level?
Par exemple, le chef de district ou de commune.
During the Khmer Rouge time,
pendant le régime des Khmer Rouge,
my question is for the period prior to the Khmer Rouge.
Ma question porte sur la période précédente du régime des Khmer Rouge.
Excuse me, could you rephrase the question again in a brief?
Réponse. Pouvez-vous reformuler votre question rapidement? Je m'excuse.
In order to make it brief, before the Khmer Rouge regime, after the couples got married, did they have the right to decide on the issue of consummation?
Avait-il le droit de décider?
Or was there a principle from the local level, for example, village or commune or district levels, order them or to give them, or that they had to have to consummate the marriage?
Selon lequel ils devaient consommer le mariage.
It was a very personal matter.
Réponse. C'était une question très personnelle.
So the outsiders, except husband and wife,
les gens de l'extérieur,
could
à l'exception deal with du mari,
even orally, they would not instruct.
Ne
to consummate
pas
a marriage.
Il
I remember
ne pas
that I met a woman who said
who
was married
mariage
before the Khmer Rouge.
Je me souviens d'une femme qui a dit s'être mariée
avant le
régime
des Khmer Rouge.
Mais elle n'a pas
consommé marriage in the beginning for 3 months or so,
son mariage,
because she was very shy and her husband
départ,
also very shy because they were assigned or instructed to marry by their parents, and it was just fine. And I think that was the case with many couples.
Et tout allait bien.
Because many couples met for the first time on the arranged wedding day.
And
maybe they were very shy and
that's
a very honest feeling.
Et ils étaient très timides. C'est un sentiment tout à fait légitime et honnête.
Thank you, expert. And Mr. President, I finish my part and I'd like to hand the floor to Mr. William Smith.
J'en ai terminé avec ma partie. Je vais passer la parole à monsieur, à mon confrère William Smith.
Thank you, Mr. President, Your Honours, Counsel, and expert.
Mr.
President, if I can just begin by providing the expert with some documents which were notified to the defence a few weeks ago, and a set of the maps that we just talked about
et la série
earlier
de cartes dont nous avons parlé tantôt.
Court officer, could you hand over the documents to the expert?
Veuillez remettre le document à
l'experte. Thank you. Good morning, Ms. Expert.
Bonjour, Madame l'experte.
Those documents look a bit daunting, but we may just refer to
volumineux,
a few pages in that book, and you'll see
je me
often at the top of the page, you'll see a large number,
en haut de la page,
or
vous verrez
on the side of the page, depending on how
numéro,
it printed out.
Plutôt sur le côté.
But
at the
same time,
I
would be asking the President
to
allow
us
to show some of the excerpts on the screen as well, so that may be easier for you to follow along.
Projeter certains extraits
à l'écran
pour que ce soit facile de suivre.
In the few minutes that we have before lunch, if I can just explain the purpose of what I will like to ask you about today,
l'objectif de mes
following
questions
on
aujourd'hui,
from my colleague Ms. Song, I would like to talk to you about marriages during the Khmer Rouge period.
And
the reason, of course, we discussed earlier marriages before the Khmer Rouge period is to get a sense of was there any contrast, was there any difference, was there any change to the marriage process during the Khmer Rouge period.
Entre le processus
and so
de mariage sous le
my
Khmer
first
Rouge
question
et
to
avant
you,
le Khmer Rouge.
during the Khmer Rouge period, where they took power in Cambodia, did the process of marriage fundamentally change? And if you can just answer in brief, and then I'll follow up with some specific questions.
Est-ce que vous pouvez être brève et je vais poser des questions de suivi par la suite.
Yes, thank you so much.
Réponse.
When the Khmer Rouge
Merci.
Took power,
lorsque les Khmer Rouge se sont emparés du pouvoir,
all the system of the marriages.
Ils ont fondamentalement changé tout le système des mariages. Ils ont tout changé.
So, in terms of your evidence earlier, you said that
Dans votre déposition tantôt,
before the Khmer Rouge period
que les mariages avant la période des Khmer Rouge étaient une question de famille à 100%
bride and groom to be,
entre
the parents.
Les futurs mariés et leurs
in
parents.
The Khmer Rouge period,
pendant
was
la période des Khmer Rouge,
authorization or the marriage process, was that a family matter,
l'autorisation de mariage, le processus de mariage, était-il une question de famille ou une question d'État? Une question des Khmer Rouge. Pouvez-vous expliquer?
The process of the marriages
Réponse.
Varied in many ways,
le processus de mariage
but
différait
Khmer Rouge
de plusieurs manières.
Absolute right
Mais le Khmer Rouge avait le droit absolu
marriage.
D'autoriser les mariages.
And just going on, and I want to follow your
L'accusation.
Book, and particularly
Je vais
your
suivre
book,
votre livre.
In relation to motherhood at war, pregnancy during the Khmer Rouge
motherhood
period.
At war,
and that's
pregnancy during the Khmer Rouge period,
10655. That's at English ERN 0132-2862. And in chapter 5 of this book, you discuss marriages during the Khmer Rouge period.
Les mariages sous la période des Khmer Rouge.
In a section of that book, you discuss
de ce
two
livre,
ways in which a man and woman would become married primarily.
Par lesquels
One,
un homme et une femme
where the marriage was authorized by the Khmer Rouge as a result of a proposal, and another where people were forced to marry and when there was no proposal.
Était autorisé
is, it,
après
is that fair to say,
de mariage,
from the way that your chapter is written, that that's your opinion, that largely marriages fell into those two categories, one that was authorized
Le mariage rentrait dans
ces deux catégories.
Mariage autorisé avec proposition et mariage forcé sans autorisation, sans proposition de mariage. Je crois que nous avons une objection.
With the expert, please hold on. And Councillor von Nuntier, you have the floor.
Président, Madame l'Expert,
yes,
veuillez patienter.
Thank you, Mr.
La défense nous tient la parole.
Good morning, Council.
La défense, merci, Monsieur le Président.
I'm revisiting a very old objection in terms
sur une
of terminology
en termes de terminologie
in questions.
Dans l'interrogatoire.
In the question from the prosecutor, I heard
Dans
the
question
words,
du procureur,
Khmer
j'ai entendu
Rouge.
Le terme
Now,
Khmer Rouge.
We're not dealing today with
aujourd'hui,
a witness, we're dealing with an expert.
Nous ne traitons pas d'un témoin, mais d'un expert.
As such, in terms of
Le terme Khmer Rouge en soi,
state power, be it local,
en termes
or on the national level,
d'autorité d'État,
really mean anything.
Au niveau
I think
local,
we should be very specific when it comes
ne
to
signifie
asking
pas grand-chose. Il faudrait être précis
expert,
lorsqu'on pose des questions à l'expert.
On what level we are talking about.
Il faudrait
Khmer
identifier
Rouge
le niveau de pouvoir dont nous parlons.
Phrase, really mean,
le Khmer Rouge en soi.
So,
est une expression facile, utile, mais qui ne signifie rien. Si le procureur veut poser des questions, il doit être précis sur le niveau de pouvoir étatique. Parle-t-il du niveau des communes, du niveau du district, du niveau de l'État? Parle-t-il de la politique du PCK, qui est également une possibilité? En d'autres termes, il faut être précis.
Because it matters whether we're dealing with local
car cela est important, dépendamment de, dépendamment de si on parle d'une politique étatique, nationale, une politique élaborée au niveau de la
presse. Monsieur le Président,
la raison pour laquelle ce terme a été utilisé, c'est parce que cette experte a utilisé l'expression
« régime des Khmer Rouges »
dans son ouvrage. Donc je suis la terminologie de l'experte. Je comprends ce que dit mon confrère.
We're trying to discuss,
mais au départ, nous essayons de débattre des concepts, et nous devons parler dans un sens large.
We'll be going into more detail,
and then we'll get a sense of que nous allons entrer dans les détails,
were the leaders ordering forced marriages,
savoir si les autorités avaient ordonné les mariages forcés, ou cela était fait au niveau local. Mais nous y arrivons. Je suis encore à l'introduction de la thématique.
The objection is overruled, and a counsel, you will have your chance, and a prosecutor, you
Maître,
may continue.
Votre tour viendra. Monsieur le procureur, veuillez poursuivre.
Thank you, Your Honor. I'm happy to continue. I do not have the time, but.
Je vous remercie, mais je remarque
expert,
que c'est déjà l'heure. Toutefois, je peux
like
tout à fait continuer. Madame l'expert,
peut-être
je plutôt m'interrompre. Un instant, dit la juge Fentz.
Thank you, Co-Prosecutor. It's now time for lunch break, and the chairman will take a break from now and resume at 1:30 this afternoon to continue our proceedings. And Ms. Expert, we will take a break now, and please return to the courtroom at 1:30 this afternoon. Security personnel, we instructed to take you some phone to the room downstairs and have him return to attend the proceedings this afternoon before 1:30. The court is now in recess.